Hi guys, in this video I'll be upgrading this 4K iMac. So, let's get started. I purchased this 4K iMac on eBay for less than £320. It's got a 3.1GHz Intel quad-core i5, 16GB of DDR3 RAM, a 512GB hard drive, and Intel Iris Pro 6200 graphics. 2 years ago, I bought the exact same 4K iMac, but it was £200 more. The reason why I bought this iMac is purely out of nostalgia. I really like M1 Max, but there is no all-in-one like this iMac. It might be old design-wise, but despite its thick bezels, it's still a beautiful design. It also has more ports than the current M1 iMac. It has a headphone jack, an SD card slot, 4 USB 3 slots, 2 Thunderbolt 2 slots, and a gigabit Ethernet slot. The design hasn't changed until last year when Apple released their M1 iMac with a brand new design. For me, this iMac is still iconic, but performance is slow. So now I'll upgrade it to a 1TB SSD. But before I do that, I will boot the Mac in order to delete the hard drive. Next, I have to go into Disk Utility, find the drive that I want to delete, and delete the drive. Once that's done, I can shut down the computer. So what I've done next is lie the iMac flat down with some pillows. I then begin to remove the adhesive. Once I disconnect two cables from the board, I can then open the screen like a book. I can clearly see the location of the hard drive. I then begin to unscrew the brackets, which holds the hard drive in place. The hard drive is connected via a SATA connector. I then remove the hard drive from its connector. Now with the hard drive removed, I can begin the installation of the SSD. I then reattach the brackets with the 4 screws. Next, I begin removing the adhesive on the screen and the iMac itself. I then begin dusting the iMac before I begin installing the screen. Using the corresponding guides, I was able to attach the strips, ensuring that they're in the right place. They go from 1 to 4 clockwise. I can now remove the adhesive cover. And begin to install the screen. I then apply a firm amount of pressure to ensure that the adhesive sticks. And last but not least, I use a microfiber cloth to remove any marks on the display. I can then go through the setup process with regards to macOS Monterey. We We can also see that the 1TB SSD has worked. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.